defiant, glamorous, powerful. Red lipstick can suggest many things. And this modern beauty staple has actually been around for over 5,000 years. Early civilizations crushed some unusual ingredients to make lipstick. In ancient Egypt, colored lips were a symbol of status for both men and women. But ancient Greek laws required prostitutes to wear lipstick in public, so men wouldn't confuse them with higher status women. In Asia, the Chinese created some of the first lip balms, and red was the most dominant color. Fast forward a few hundred years, and red lips still had a bad reputation in Europe. In England, lipstick was seen to mark its wearer as an incarnation of the devil. But Britain's Queen Elizabeth I loved the color, and red lips were popularized during her reign. She believed it had healing and protective properties. Although we now know the opposite was true, many lip colors were made from toxic substances. Later, opinions in Britain changed again. Queen Victoria deemed the colour to be impolite, though some women still applied it in secret. Around the same time in France, a full face of makeup, including lip rouge, was actually de rigueur for women of good standing. And in the 1900s, the suffragette movement reclaimed red lips in rebellion, wearing it on marches. During World War II, the Allies adopted red lipstick as a patriotic symbol, particularly as Hitler hated it. Post-war, red lips found fame in Hollywood, becoming the signature of stars from Marilyn Monroe to Elizabeth Taylor. But the look also has a history of being progressive and transgressive, punctuating many pop culture moments. Today, despite beauty products and trends being more varied than ever before, red lipstick, in its myriad shades, is still charged with meaning and a way to make a statement, whatever that might be.